Hello friends, I am Mr. Ajit, assistant professor from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am going to discuss about deadlocks in operating system. Now the objectives are, we have to understand the concept of deadlock and the required conditions to create deadlock in the processing. The primary goals are processes and their states, system model followed by the operating system, concepts of deadlock, and conditions responsible to create deadlock. Now, what is process? Process is an instance of computer program is being executed currently. Normally, process has got two states. The first is running state, and second is the wait state. Now, in running state, the process is supplied to CPU. It is acquiring all the required resources for execution, and the process is executed by the CPU. And second is the waiting state. There are some cases where the processor doesn't find required resources available. So in that case, CPU forces that process from running state to wait state. This one more term is coming here, is called multiple programming. That is multi-programming. Now in this case, the CPU is going to execute number of processes at the same time. Now, what are different resources required by a process for execution? Now, during execution, the process normally required memory, some devices, some I/O devices, and a CPU. So, we have to carefully share all these resources between the processes. Now, normally, all the processes when it get for execution in the CPU, he follows one system model. So for example, one process required some resource. So when that process created for execution and he suppose wants some resource for use, so he first requests the resource towards the operating system. Now operating system give the control of this resource to the process if it is available. It is suppose not available, then process has to wait. Suppose process finds the required resource from the operating system, then he will use that resource for its execution, and after some time, means when he complete the process, he will again give back the control of that resource back to the operating system. Now here, one case is to be remembered. The process cannot snatch the resource from other process forcefully to make himself executed from the CPU. So forceful getting resource for use is not allowed. What is deadlock here? If you see carefully from the diagram here, there are two processes P1 and P2. Now P1 is having a resource 1 is allocated already by him, and whereas P2 is having resource number 2. The darker arrows are showing that the resource 1 is allocated to process P1 already, and P2 is held by process number 2. Now for P1's execution, the P1 require one more resource, that is resource 2, which is held already by P2, and whereas the P2 also want one more resource for its execution, that is resource number 2. Now in this case, you'll find that both processes are waiting to get the other's resources for execution. So in this case, no process get executed, and this kind of situation is called as a deadlock. Now there are four conditions are necessary to create deadlock. The first is mutual exclusion, second is hold and wait, third is no preemption, and fourth is circular wait. Now we'll see one by one what is the meaning of mutual exclusion. Now this is a case where suppose there are two processes are waiting for getting resource to be used here. So when one process is using one resource, then other process has to wait because the resource which is available is not shareable. For example, a case of printer. Suppose some process use printer for printing here. So in that case, other process has to wait. The second condition which is necessary is hold and wait. Now hold and wait is just like human behavior, because we know here, whenever the things become available to human, we grab that and wait for other things to become available here. Similarly, the process, suppose want to get executed, he will first find the required resources available. He will hold that process, hold that resource with him, and wait for other resources to become free. And after that, he will execute himself. The meaning is that when process become ready for execution, he will grab all the required resources available and wait for remaining to become available. Now, next is no preemption. For example, one process is executing himself, and suppose another process want his resource for its execution here. Now, in that case, the other process is not allowed to stop the first process forcefully. That is, he has to wait until the first process complete, and then he will get the resource released by the first process, and then he can start his execution. Let us see some example here. Now, actually, to create deadlock here, we have to create all these conditions simultaneously. That is, all these above mentioned conditions should be there, occurring at the same time. Just see the example here in my diagram. You are seeing the three processes P1, P2 and P3. Naturally, P1 is waiting for resource to release from process P2 here. Similarly, the process P2 is waiting to get resources from P3. Now, can you say that in this condition, can we create deadlock here? Just think a moment here. Now, in this case, deadlock is not possible. Let's see what happens here. Now, we know here the P3 is having its resource available to him. So, after some time, you find that P3 execute himself completely. Then he will allocate its resources to process P2. And then process P2 is going to execute himself. And then he will release the resource held by himself to the process P1. That is, in this way, after some time, you find that the process P3 will execute initially, then P2 and P1. That is, in this case, we will not find any kind of deadlock there. Now, what is the condition required to create deadlock here? Now, in this case, I just modified diagram slightly here. Now, in this case, P1 wait for resource from P2, P2 wait for resource from P3, and P3 waits for resource from P1. Now, in this case, we are having a loop is present here. It is normally called a circular wait condition there. Just see what happens in this one. Now, in this case, P2 will not get executed unless P3 is executed here. But we know here P3 is also waiting for getting resources to be released by process P1 here. Now, in this case, you will see that any of the processes available is not executed at any time here. Now, this is the condition we call as a deadlock here. That is, we can summarize here that to create deadlock, there should be four conditions should be available. First is mutual exclusion. Second is hold and wait. Third is no preemption. And fourth is circular wait. One more thing is that to create deadlock in the system, these conditions should be present at the same time here. If anyone is not available, there will not be a deadlock here. Now, in this, we can have the questions like describe deadlock in operating system and describe four required conditions responsible for creating a deadlock. These are my references. Thank you, friends.